All right, and we're back. That was a nice break. This song is going hard. That is some bass. Welcome back. This is The Table. I'm your host, Marlon. And let's just jump right back in. Let's get a little intimate. Let's talk about thirst season. We had our cupping season, which was September through December. We had our breakup season, which is January through May. And now we're hitting thirst season. And the reason I want to talk about thirst season is because I love thirst season. Everyone's available. Everyone just wants to fuck each other like rabbits. It's disgusting. Let me give you an analogy. High school, like senior year, I think is super funny. Throwing it back to high school. Senior year, leading up to summer, when everyone's about to graduate, it's the most disgusting time I've ever seen in my life. Like, everyone's hormones are just at its peak. Like, everyone just wants to fuck that one person they couldn't have. They just were like, you know what, I'm gonna try. I'm gonna hook up with the most random of people. It's like a numbers game. And ladies, I know you're aware of this. Your DMs be blowing up in the summer. Because I know, I send you those DMs. I am aware that your DMs be blowing up, okay? I'm the one sending those DMs. I am not ashamed of my actions, nor should you be, because it's thirst season. Let's take advantage of it. Let's have some fun. Let's meet some new people and just have a good old time. Let's just have a ball. However, let's respect one another, okay? Let's keep in consideration our emotions, okay, for a second. And this is a nice segue to Marlon's story time about his bad thirst season experience. So it's 2015. Your boy just graduated high school. And now Tinder is my best friend because I'm thirsty as hell. And after countless hours of swiping left and right, I come to this one girl, super pretty, green eyes, like she's gorgeous. Let's just call her Vanessa, okay? I don't want to say her name, but let's call her Vanessa. Vanessa. You know any Vanessas? Yeah, fucking Vanessas. She's really sweet. We kicked it off. And of course, one thing led to another, and we started hooking up. And she was really sweet. And, you know, I just came out of high school. I was super thirsty. And I just couldn't have enough, and I told myself, you know, let's go meet someone else. I don't know if you call this cheating. Like, we're not dating or anything, we're just hooking up. So now I'm gonna go find someone else to hook up with at the same time. it was a really bad idea, let's just say that. I met this other girl, I'm not gonna say where I met her, but I met this girl. We were friends at first, but then it became more than just a friendship. And then we started hooking up, and one thing led to another, and now we're all hooking up. We're just like, not together, but like I'm hooking up with one girl, and then like I'm going. I sound like a complete douchebag. I didn't notice how much of a douchebag I was gonna sound telling the story, but let's just say I'm in a triangle of love. I'm in a love triangle, and of course, me being me, that wasn't enough, and so I wandered off. And I wanted to find more. I was on a journey. I felt like I was catching Pokemon. I gotta catch them all, I said. It was a terrible idea. And of course, now we're at our third person. And let's just say she is an ex-lover. It was a really bad idea. I don't know what the fuck I was thinking. It was the worst decision I've ever made in my life. And I look back at it and it's just so stupid. Because now I'm in a love square. And if you've ever been in a love square, it's very time consuming. And this was not easy to maintain, okay? Very difficult if you ask me. Imagine trying to hang out with three different girls in the span of a week. That's how stupid I was, okay? That's how fucking stupid I was. How did I think this was gonna work? And of course, this all came crashing down because I got exposed. I got exposed. It was the most embarrassing thing of my life. And how did I get exposed? Well, I thought it'd be a good idea to invite two of the girls that I was like hooking up with to a party. I thought I was like Hugh Hefner or something. And so now what is going on is that one of the girls is like super drunk, and she already has an idea what's going on. I don't know if I told her or something. I don't know what the hell's going on, but she knows. And so she blunt straight out says, "Hey, Marlon is hooking up with all of us. There's another girl, and he's playing every single one of us. Now you got a crowd of people surrounding us like, wow, what an asshole. And it's just really awkward. And oh my God, I think someone threw a drink at me. I don't know who threw it. Like, I feel like one of the girls threw a drink at me. And I was like, oh shit, this is awkward as fuck. Now I got like one girl crying. I got two girls crying. It's just really embarrassing. And then I got people looking at me like, what the fuck did he do? And it was just an embarrassing ass moment. It was just really bad. I felt like such a dick. And luckily the other girl wasn't there. I think she was on vacation. I don't know. I remember she was in Mexico. Fucking Vanessa. Soaking it up in the sun. Stress-free. However, the message did carry out to her. I don't know, like, probably a message in a bottle. But yeah, she texted me, and she was like, please don't ever talk to me again. Don't text me. Bye. Like, with the B-Y-E period. Bye. And I was like, fuck. I was really bummed, because I think I just liked her because of her eyes. Like, she has some really nice eyes. Like, she's really nice. I was like, wow. I think that's the only reason I was so fixed on her. But with that, let's respect one another. Let's have a nice thirst season. Let's play within the rules. Let's remember we all have emotions. And let's respect one another. Keep in mind that we all want to be happy, all right? Let's not make each other all sad. Let's not be sad. I hate being sad. It sucks. But damn. I'm going to put the podcast to a close. It's been fun. I hope y'all have a great morning. Enjoy your day. I'm glad you spent it with me in this podcast, The Table, with your boy, your host, Marlon Vela. I really enjoy this podcast. It's so much fun. I get to share what's on my mind, and you guys can talk to me. Episode 1 was awesome because you guys DM'd me like crazy, and it's just fun. So have a great morning. This is The Table, and I'll see you in the next episode. And share this with your friends. Share this with your mom. Share this with your dad, your girlfriend, your dog, your cat, your hamster, that homeless cat that lives outside that just keeps tapping on your window for some grub. Damn, it's really early for me. But I hope you guys have a wonderful morning. And this is The Table. This is your boy, Marlon. Before I end this, don't forget to DM me at AVANTGRANDS Instagram. Follow me. Let me know how you feel about the podcast, and I'll see you in the next one. Hasta luego. See ya. Fuck. All right. Bye.